Let us begin Bhagavad Gita, verse number 8 of 7th chapter. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Raso Hamapsu Kaunteya Prabhasmi Sashashurya Yohum Pranavasarva Vedesho Shabdakhe Paurusham Nurushu. Bhagavan Krishna is explaining the two aspects of Ishwaratvam, the real nature of Ishwara. He defined that there are two kinds of natures, higher nature and lower nature. Higher nature as told is para prakriti, lower nature is called apara prakriti. This both can be said in scientific language, matter and consciousness. But because being gross material, our mind is very gross, it believes because of the matter conscious exist. For example, if I ask you to a question, the question is because of you the body exists or because of the body you exist. What would be the answer? You will confirm yourself because of me the body exists. Is it so? No. Maximum amount of people will say because of my body I exist. Before the body I was not there. You should remember the teaching from the second chapter. Bahuni megati tani janmani tava charjuna tanya ham veda sarvani natvam vetha parantapa. So many shariras have gone, Arjuna, that I am aware, but you are not. In the same way here, so when he says, matter and consciousness is my own swarupa. Matter seems to be the cause of the consciousness, but consciousness is the cause of the matter. Because of the me alone, body can exist, otherwise not. I am the shelter, I am the substratum of this physical body. In the same way, the consciousness, the collective consciousness is the substratum of this collective, grossified world. But our mind doesn't have the capacity to accept this fact because mind is a product of this grossified world. It doesn't have an ability, strength to digest the reality. The subtlest things are more stronger than the gross materials. This gross material seems to be strong. It's wrong because our mind and body, they are having a feel at home sense. Do you understand what I say? Feel at home sense, because body is vulnerable. When I hit a wall, so wall is more stronger than me, therefore I confirm the wall is more stronger than me, the rock is more stronger than me. But this rock and mountain, all kinds of so-called strong, they seem to be strong material. They are not strong. The cause of them are subtlest things. That's invention in science made a revolution. Therefore, in positive way we have grown a lot, in the negative way we found the nuclear bombs. The nuclear is breaking all this atom. That's what the secret. The subtlest energy becomes more powerful than the grossified world. When Bhagavan says, Aham rasaha. Aham rasaha means I am the taste of the water. Between taste and water, water becomes the effect, taste becomes the cause. I am the cause of the water. If you remove the cause from the water, water won't be there. Because when you realize everything is nothing but God, we may not have the capacity to digest it. It takes time. Therefore, my Acharya used to say, when you study about Ishvara, you can understand in the buddhi everything is nothing but Ishvara. But the change which has to be taken place in our mind, that attitudinal change will take place gradually, because your transaction depends on your perception. your ideology. The perception is constructed by the age, not in one day and night. You could see that the Indian, we do have our own perception about the life, about the patriotism. These, all the people in various countries, they have their own uniqueness towards the life and patriotism. Every mind is different because of what? Because of the environment, because of the societies, because of the culture, because of their environment. Completely it differs, people to people, society to society, nation to nation. But especially when you understand about the God, the Sanatana Dharma, it entirely differs from all other dharmas. It says the glorified world has got a caste which is not evolved as a name and form. It is not manifested at all, but it is the substratum called Ishvaraha. The word Ishvaraha we find in Vedas, therefore the meaning should be understood according to the teaching of the Vedas. And these Vedas are bringing a valid method to imply the knowledge. That's what the process is going on. Therefore, we divided the bhakti itself. There are three levels according to the knowledge, because knowledge is three levels. According to the knowledge, you get the bhakti. When you accept God as the author of or a creator of the world, now for you, God is the creator. God and world is separate. Now you fix one God. That God is known as your Ishta Devata. You can select so many gods we do have. You know, we have innumerable gods. You can select according to the personality. If you are a stouty person, you can select Lord Ganesha is the Lord, your Ishta Devata. If you want to have a handsome deity, you can select Mahavishnu, he is very handsome. If you want to select a kind of, you know, a dazzling personality, you select Lord Shiva as your Ishta Devata, as the creator. You are creating a perception by accepting that form and glories. And every form is given a pattern of worshipping method. The pattern, because every god, it has got different form. Lord Shiva is with Trishula, but Lord Mahavishnu with Shankha and Chakra, conch and the Sudarshana Chakra. Every god has got different philosophy, but that all philosophy is connected with one philosophy. It's a beautiful infrastructure. When you fix one god, you believe that he is alone god, called Ekarupa Bhakti. That Abhinna Nimitta Upadana Karana Ishwaraha is accepted. The god alone can be the cause, the main substratum of the universe. Therefore, what? That God as a creator. When you fix, you get Ekarupa Bhakti, that is the preliminary stage. According to the knowledge, you get the bhakti. So, this God as the creator gets Ekarupa Bhakti. Then, God created the world and he has become world itself. Then you get Anekarupa Bhakti. The bhakti changes. You are grown a little bit. Now, in the Ekarupa Bhakti, God is given one form. But in Anekarupa Bhakti, God is not given in any form. But the world is given as the form. Therefore, you can see, when we are going to discuss about Vishwarupa Darshanam, so you can see in the Lord, all the creatures are given in the form of Lord Mahavishnu with, you know, so many thousands of head, thousands of hands, and thousands of eyes. Sahasra Shirusha Purushaha Sahasraksha Sahasrapat Sabhumim Vishvato Vritva Atyatishthadashangulam Purusha Evedagum Sarvam Yad Bhotanyachabhavyam Udamrutatvasyeshanaha. yadannena tirohati. So these all things, the whole world, whatever the form, whatever the nature, whatever the nature means, whatever the characteristic they, all of them together is a sharira of Ishvara. Therefore, aneka rupa bhakti. Now, the world has got different dimension. Every dimension has got cause and effect and reaction. Water means endowed with taste. Now, Bhagavan separates taste and water, and he fixes water means the taste is the cause, water is the effect. I am nothing but the taste means what? I am nothing but the cause of the element called water. Now, water is what? Water is also Bhagavan. This is the second level understanding I tell you. The world has to be understood as mithya. In third level understanding, that will come in forthcoming chapter, after 12th chapter. So now itself he will bring in 9th chapter. But we have to be careful enough. When you get the knowledge, the God itself has become the world, then what has to be the perception of you? When we go to the temple, when we see Balaji, we are mesmerized. You know, that few seconds, few minutes, we forget ourselves. We are amazed. The same Balaji, same Venkateswara exists everywhere means what? Every second that you have to amaze. You have to look, your body is nothing but Ishvara. Everything is Ishvara. That's what the attitudinal change should take place. That attitudinal change needs to have certain period of time, because we are trained in a particular pattern to set our perception, to set our emotions. Because you could see that in our people itself, according to the place they express their emotions. You can see Japanese. So when they express, while talking itself, their body language, and they are very flourishing, you know, with lots of facial reactions. But these British people, very less reaction. And lengthening, you know, slang Americans. American English is something different. Something different, sometimes beautiful. British, they speak without opening the mouth. We, the Indians, we open a lot the mouth. It's unique, isn't it? So whatever the difference are there in the world, everything is nothing but Ishvara. That is the glory of Ishvara. Therefore, he picks the objects, you know, the objects very much related to human life, to set a proper attitudinal change. To bring the attitudinal change is the great thing. It is not based on our belief. It cannot be based on our belief. When you construct an attitude based on your belief, when belief is gone, the attitude also will be gone. In the same way, I know a great personality who constructed 3 temples. Now he is not going to the temples because he lost his son. He started fighting with the God. I am not going to see him. I won't see him. How much I believed him. That belief, human mind, it knows how to believe, and it also does the job this belief. Therefore, we have to be careful with our own mind. When I say you have to mind, don't be with not minding that. Don't mind. You know, whenever I see like this, I want to pinch a little bit more. That you know, that understanding. Words are limited. The understanding which I have, which is given by my gurus, I would like to express this, because so whatever the expressions we may have, it is not enough. God means what? Everything. God is everything. The truth it removes all kinds of fears, problems. It gives the peaceful things. Swamiji, it gives peaceful things means why are you making yourself, so emotional means. So when we experience it, when we teach about Ishvara, that urge, the experience we struggled for so many years, the people should not struggle like that. They have to get in simple way, in easy way, and such a way they should not miss it. That's what my effort while teaching this portion is very important, because the God concept is not depending on our belief system. And God is not an emotional or intelligent condition. God is the fact. We have to realize it, not to believe, not to accept. You have to realize it. When you realized, you still have to work to change your attitude. He said, Prabhasme Shashi Surya Yoho. I am the element power of sun and moon. Pranava Sarva Vedeshu. Pranavaha means Omkaraha. Om means a short portion of Om. Avati Rakshati Iti Om. That which protects. A potential power called Mula Mantra. So that we will see later on. There is a place where we are going to see the detail about mantras. Still I can give, in Lalita Sahasranama Bhashya. Sri Lalita Sahasranama, which was taught by Lord Mahavishnu in the form of Hayagriva, having horse feeds to Agastya Maharishi. And one Rishi, I consider him as a Rishi, who commented on Bhaskarananda, Swami Bhaskarananda. But Bhaskara Raya, his Purvashram's name, this Bhaskara Raya, he has commented on that. He accepts as the Vivarta Upadana Karana Ishwaraha. But in Lalita Sahasranama, he has given a detail how many mantras we do have. This one is Mula Mantra. From that Mula Mantra, every mantra has derived. Now, Om must be given as a potential form. Therefore, we use this Om with all mantras. And one more shloka also says, when Brahma, Lord Brahma wants to create the world, when he thought of creating the world, so two words came piercing his mouth. Omkarashchatha shabdashcha dvavetau brahmanapura kantham bhitva vinaryatau tasman mangalikavu bhau. When he thought of creating the world, these two words came. It manifested himself. Om and Atha. You can see this, both of them are auspicious. So anything you begin, you should begin with Om. If Shanti Mantra, Om. Veda Mantra, Om. If you want to write anything, you begin with Om. And this Atha also, which is equal to the sound Om. Atha. Therefore, Atha to Dharma Jignyasa, Atha to Brahma Jignyasa, Atha Yoga Anushasanam. So Atha, Atha, Atha. You need not to have a separate prayer. Because in ancient time, whatever you write, you should begin with the prayer. The prayer in the beginning. The prayer should be in the middle. Prayer also should be at the end. There are also norms. The prayer. The prayer on Saguna Tattva. Prayer on Guru. Prayer on Ishvara as a Nirguna Tattva. The content, all these were the conditions in ancient time. If they want to write, they have their own structure. It has to be given in the particular structure, otherwise it won't be acceptable. Now every one of us, we are the author of Medium. We have blogs and we have the page, we have the Facebook, and we do have the Twitter, Instagram, so many exposures. But in those times, so there were pandits, means all the knowledge people, very highly scholarly people. They decide what kind of scriptures to be accepted by the committee. There it was the condition, Om, Omkaraha. And this Omkara is known as Pranavaha, that which protects, that which nourishes, that which rejuvenates. So Omkara is nothing but the sound from which all Veda mantras came. Mantra means manana trayate iti mantraha. Mantra means a construction. It's a special construction, construction which we see as a building construction. An architect, he gives the plan for a building. Now, this blueprint which he gives, that blueprint alone becomes a gross building. So, which is stronger in between these two? This blueprinting of the building. And people say, Swamiji, that blueprinting, after the construction of the building, it becomes useless. No, this plan alone executed in the building. Now the plan has become the building. Now you cannot separate the plan and the building. If you remove the plan from that building, the grass things. So which seems to be very grass, it will fail you. If the plan is wrong, if the plan is not proper, the building won't be there. The same way, this every word, every sound of Vedas are from Om. So if you remove Om, no sound. If there is no sound, no manifestation. Vedas are the foundation of the creation. Some people cannot accept it, but if I say in this way, the sound is the cause of the manifestation. Now it's okay, a little bit okay, sound. Yeah, I also accept, because without the sound, nothing is there. Even when an ant travels, it has got its own sound. Our ears are not capable to hear it. In the same way, when this bigger earth, the huge surfaced earth, when it revolves, it revolves and it also rotates. Do you hear the sound? No. So our hearing capacity, they do have limitation. We cannot hear beyond the decibel point, and under that, less our decimal the sound. So this is the reality. Our mind can think for certain limitation. If it is so subtlest, we cannot understand. If it is so grosser than us, we cannot understand. Therefore, God says, you accept, Om is a mantra moolam. Therefore, it is known as moola mantra. And there are so many steps. From this moola mantra alone, Bija mantra arrives. Bija mantra means what? Bija means seed. So they are different seeds containing the potential form. When you say Om Namo Narayanaya, that is, so it's a Maha mantra. Namo Narayanaya. Om Ashtakshari. You include Om. So the syllables, when there is one syllable, that mantra is known as Pindam. Bhaskara Raya says, if a mantra has got two letters, two syllables, known as Kartari, If it has got 3 syllable up to 9 syllable, is known as Bija Mantras. These Bija Mantras are innumerable. Om Shrim Hrim Klim Lam Ganganapataye Varavarada Sarvajanam Mevashamana Yasvaha. Om Shrim Hrim Klim Glaum. So many these Bija Mantras. So Sakramala Varayum. So when you do puja in Shri Vidya, Sahasakramala Varayum, it's a Bija Mantra. When you do offer, you know, the salutation to your rishis, I'm Klaim Savoho. Om Shrim Hrim Klim Glam Ganganapataye Varavarda Sarvajanam Nevasamane. So like this kind of Bija Mantras, which contains, so 3 to 9. If a mantra contains more than 9 syllable, up to 20 syllable, called mantra. Okay, so this is the inner division of the mantra. But for us, everything is nothing but mantra. If we consider Lalita Sahasranama, Lalita Sahasranama is a long mantra, one mantra. The 1000 names become one mantra. It's a glory given by Lord Mahavishnu. So definitely we will see in future the Lalita Sahasranama Bhashya. So I would like to give it a Bhashya teaching. So let us see, Lord Venkateswara may provide an environment, energy and opportunity for all of us. Okay. Now, this is the mantra which contains from 10 syllable to 20 syllables are called mantra. If a mantra contains more than 20 syllables, there is no limitations, called mala mantra. Pindam means 1 syllable, Kartari means 2 syllables, Bijam means 3 to 9 syllables, and Mantraha means 10 to 20 syllables, and Mala means more than 20 syllables. These are all the varieties of mantras in the divisions. There are male mantras and female mantras also there. So these all mantras, which is a proper construction, that's what I was talking about. A mantra means it's a construction. It has got its own duration. You cannot violate it. You should not. In the same way, if you want to gain the mantra, you need to have a guru and Ishwara's grace. So these Vedic mantras are construction. Therefore, even the mistake which was committed by our rishis, we accept as the arsham. Arsha prayogaha means we don't touch it. Even Satyameva Jayate, that is the logo, isn't it? Our constitution we do have. So that is grammatically is not correct. Satyameva Jayate has to be there, but it is there Jayate, because the rishis have created it. We are not going to touch. If we wanted to do corrections, then it will be, the system will be broken. Therefore, the infrastructures should not be broken. For that purpose alone, we don't touch any mantra. We are not given the rights for it. That's what mantra. So the Vedas are full of mantras. Those mantras are nothing but from Om. That Om is me. You know, this is the teaching of Bhagavan Krishna. And he says, Vedas are in the form of sound. The sound is nothing but me. That also he says, Ke Shabdaha. Ke means in the space. I am the sound. So sound and space, so they are the two reality of one factor. Without sound, you cannot see the space. Where there is a space, sound is tanmatra, it is very much available. Paurusham nirushu. Paurusham nirushu means, so this, the capacity to produce the next generation, progeny. So I am the cause of entire creation. That's what, this is what is said, Sutre Manigana Iva. So many generation. It seems to be immediate cause. No, the real cause is Ishvara. He brings the lineage, parampara, guru shishya parampara, and father son parampara. Some people may get angry. Why cannot be father, daughter, mom, son? It's okay, parampara. It's a parampara. So parampara means what? Lineage. It comes. So when you go this process of understanding, you will set a proper attitudinal change towards the world, towards ourselves. Then every day becomes magic for the person who realizes, who could able to digest it. We will continue in the next class tomorrow, in the next episode. Harihi Om.